What's up, Michael here from Fitter Media, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to make a Lottie animation as a background in Webflow, and in fact, it is so easy. You're going to be able to do this in just a few steps, and it's only going to take you a few minutes. So without any further ado, let's hop right into this tutorial. If you find it helpful, be sure to subscribe because we drop a lot of content just like this one. So let's go back to the examples really quick. So this example, as you can see, these waves are the Lottie animation. And this text in the background is just a default heading element. So this kind of shows how you can layer Lottie animations instead of just using them purely as the background. These are just some really simple examples. If we scroll up, we have this other example where we kind of have these sound waves in the background. Pretty much any Lottie animation that you have and you want to make it as a background, you'll be able to using this method. So let's go out of preview mode and let's open up each of these examples in the navigator. So not counting the heading elements because those don't really matter. This just takes two elements to complete. So we, one, need a wrapper that is set to relative, and then we need our Lottie animation, and this is going to be set to absolute. So what we're going to do is we are just going to quickly hide these and we are going to build these from scratch so that you can see all of the settings we need to set. So with those out of the way, we're first going to drop in a div block. And then this div block is going to be the wrapper. So I'm just going to name this wrapper. You can technically name it whatever you want. Once that is done, you want to set the width to 100% and then the min height to 100VH. This is just going to make sure that it takes up the entire vertical space of the screen. So it doesn't matter if you are on a mobile phone or a computer, it will take up the vertical height. Now, if you don't want your background to take up the vertical height, you don't need to do this. But pretty much if you have a background already and you just want to add a Lottie to it, you can kind of avoid some of these changes or styles that I'm setting, except for the following one that I'm going to do now. And that is you want to set the wrapper to position relative, and then you want to set the overflow to hidden. Those are the two that you need to have. But again, if you have a different background that is like only taking up half the screen, you can kind of ignore these width and height because that's kind of just specific to this example. Once that's done, you're going to want to drop in a Lottie animation. Make sure that is inside of the wrapper. And then from here, we are going to add a Lottie. If you've never uploaded a Lottie to Webflow before, all you have to do is drop it into the asset panel, just like a photo or an image. And then from here, we're just going to select it. And we're going to preview this to make sure it's working. And as you can see, it is working just fine. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to name this Lottie. Again, you can name it whatever you want. And then for my specific example, I'm going to go to settings and I'm going to set it to loop so that if I preview this, it should keep looping over and over again. Okay, so once that's done, with your Lottie selected, you want to go back to the style panel. And then we are going to set just a few more styles here. So first you want to make the width 100% and then the height 100%. And then we want to set the fit to cover, and then we want to set the position to absolute, and then within the position settings we want to set it to full. And then what we can do is we can preview this, and this Lottie animation is now the background for this section. So what we can do is we can actually add in different elements now. So I'll add in a heading, and then I'm going to center it by just selecting the wrapper, setting this to flex, and then I'm going to center it. And you can now see that our Lottie image or animation is now the background. However, you can see that that's kind of actually wrong because it's more so in the foreground because it's kind of hard to tell with this animation, but it's actually over top of the text. So what we can do in this scenario is we can either make the Lottie animation go to the background by setting the Z index to -1. And then now if we preview this, you can see it is now behind the text. However, if you already have some background elements like a background color or a background image, it may put the Lottie behind that. So there's a few different ways you can handle that. You can set index Z indexes for those elements as well. Or you can forget adding the Z index to the Lottie animation, and you can add it directly to the elements on top. So for this heading, we're just going to call this a heading. And then we could set this Z index to 1 like it is here. And then if we preview this, the Lottie animation is now behind it. So either one of those methods work, but that is how you can set a Lottie animation as a background. You can see if I were to adjust the height of this wrapper, the Lottie animation changes with it. So it resizes the Lottie animation in the background perfectly to make sure it matches the height of the section that you wanted on. So I hope this was helpful. If you're having any issues with this or anything else in Webflow, we do offer one-on-one Webflow consulting where you can hop on a call with us and we'll help you out for an hour. Or if you are looking for some ongoing Webflow work, we offer unlimited Webflow development at a flat monthly rate. There'll be links to both of those in the description below.